What's going on, you guys? It's Cody Steck. Welcome back to another video. In this one, I'm going to cover 5 reasons why most real estate investors fail. This is a subject that I wanted to cover because I've seen a lot of real estate investors going out into the market, but failing to acquire their first property, their second, their third property, because they don't follow these things that you need to know about if you're looking at investing in real estate. I'm a real estate investor myself. I have 15 units and I've helped a number of investors acquire their own rental properties as well. So really what it comes down to is the reason why there's so many people interested in real estate, but so many of them fail to take action and actually get a property, you know, get their first property or maybe even grow their portfolio that they have, comes down to these 5 reasons. So without further ado, let's just jump into it. Number one here on our list is that they don't prepare properly. They don't get their funds in a row. They don't pre-qualify. They don't go through that process of actually figuring out how much they can afford and what type of property they're actually looking for. They fail to prepare from the very beginning. Now, I also should mention that when I talk about these 5 things here in this video, these are obviously things that you should be doing if you're looking at acquiring property. I think that's a given, but I just want to state that here for you bluntly. So number one, they don't prepare. They don't go through the pre-qualification process. They get ahead of themselves and start looking at property and wanting to see stuff in person before they actually get their ducks in a row, get their funds ready, and pre-qualify. So that's going to be the first thing you need to do. You need to go out there, get pre-qualified, talk to a bank, talk to a lender. I know that so many people have issues with filling out an application before they've actually got a property, but this is the wrong way to look at it. Most people get really worried about the credit check that they're gonna have on their credit when they go and apply for that mortgage, but this is the wrong way to look at it. You don't need to be worried about that. Yeah, it's gonna ding you a couple points, but if you're really serious about purchasing property, you need to go through that pre-qualification process, talk to the bank, and make sure that you're ready to pull the trigger. You need to have your down payment funds set up and finish off as much of the application as you can up front to simplify the process once you get into it. So that's the first reason on our list here, is that most investors fail to prepare properly. Now, the second reason why investors fail is because they don't take action on a daily basis. They're not looking at properties daily and they tend to lose interest over time. I see a lot of people who jump into the market and say, yeah, I want to buy a rental property. And they might look for a couple of days and then they say, ah, there's nothing out there, you know, and they give up and they forget about the idea altogether. This is the wrong way to look at it. Right now, in 99% of the markets across the United States, the market is moving very quick. If you just go on to the MLS at any given time and look at properties, there's a 99% chance that what you see on there is going to be overpriced and it's not going to be a deal. You really need to be looking at the market on a regular basis so that when those deals come up, when those properties come up that are actually deals, you will be able to jump on it right away and you will know that that's the property that you've been looking for. Now, the third reason why investors fail is because they don't actually know what numbers they're looking for. Most investors, if you ask them, hey, what are the numbers that you need on a property? They would say, oh, you know, I don't know, I'm just looking for a deal, right? They can't tell you if they're looking for a certain cash on cash return, an appreciation rate, a cap rate, a net income, you know, tax benefits, what they're going to be able to write off with a cost segregation. These are things that most investors don't know. However, if you find an investor who knows what they're looking for, they will have these numbers already in their head and say, I'm looking for at least a 6% cap rate, or I want a 10% cash on cash return. Whatever it may be, an experienced investor who's ready to pull the trigger is going to know what their numbers are and what they're looking for. So if you need to go through some spreadsheets or calculators to figure out what those numbers will be, then that's something you're gonna have to do. You wanna know what these numbers are up front so that when a deal comes up, you can just input what the rents are, what the expenses will be, and what your debt service is gonna be, and that's gonna spit out a number and say, okay, your cash on cash return is this, your net income is this, your cap rate is this, and those are the things that you need to be looking for and know what those numbers are so that when that property comes up, you know, hey, this meets my criteria, I need to jump on it. And that kind of leads us right here into reason number 4 on why most investors fail. The 4th reason why investors fail is because they don't take action on making an offer. When you don't know your numbers, it's really hard to make an offer on a property and know if it's actually a deal or not. You know, a lot of people get scared away because of that. However, when you know your numbers, you're going to be able to look at a property and say, this meets my cash on cash return, this meets my cap rate, this meets my XYZ return that I want, and you're going to be able to pull the trigger immediately by making an offer right away. Now, this is especially true for newer investors. If it's your first property or maybe even your second, third, or fourth property, you're gonna get a little bit scared when making that first initial offer. However, you have to trust in the process. You have to trust in your network, you know, with who you've been talking to, with your agent, with your lender, that this is gonna work out. And you have to trust the experience and the, you know, the work that you've put in, the research, to know if that deal, if that property is a deal or not. So you really have to trust the process and just jump into it. You have to take action and make that offer. And that leads us into reason number five, why investors fail is because they don't network with the right people. When you're going out there and you're looking for investment properties, you need to be talking to everybody that you can and say, look, I'm a buyer of real estate. I'm looking for this type of deal. If this deal comes up, make sure to call me because I would like to buy it. You need to be talking with agents, with other investors, and even with homeowners saying, hey, I'm looking for real estate. Do you know anybody who has this type of deal? You would be surprised how many deals I've come across just by randomly, you know, being on the phone with a friend or with another agent or investor and just saying, hey, I'm looking for this type of property, or I've got a client looking for this type of property. Do you have anything? And sure enough, they'll say, yeah, actually I do have something like that. So you need to be networking and you need to consistently tell other people that, hey, I'm looking for this type of property, and you're going to see deals start to pop up. So let me give you an example. Like I was just saying, I was actually talking to a fellow friend and agent and investor. He's actually all three about real estate. And we were just talking about something that was unrelated. We were talking about a rental property that I already owned. He said, hey, I'm looking at buying one down the street. I would like to, you know, just pick your brain about some things about the property. And I said, yeah, sure. So whatever. So we talk about some things, you know, about the property. And then at the end, I say, hey, I've got some 1031 exchange money coming up. Do you have anything that, you know, do you know of any deals out there? And he said, you know what? Actually, I do. I've got a duplex coming up next week. Sure enough, that turned into a deal for me. I got that deal off market before it even hit the market and was able to buy it directly from the seller with that agent friend representing me during that process. So it was a win-win-win. I got the deal, my agent friend got the commission, and the seller got the property sold for a very good price. Funny enough, during that process, about 2 weeks into it, that agent friend investor calls me up and says, hey, are you interested in a second property? This same seller actually has another house that he wants to sell, and the numbers look pretty decent. You might be interested. And I said, let me see what I can do. Sure enough, took down the second deal as well. So I actually got two deals out of that one phone call, totally by chance, just by talking to this guy at the right time. So I just got kind of lucky there, but it ended up working out and being a great deal. So these are the types of examples that I want to share with you guys here on this channel. If you enjoyed this, give me a thumbs up here on the video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so. And drop a comment. Let me know what investment properties you're looking at. If this is your, you know, if you're just a first-time investor, or if you already own properties and you're looking to acquire more, I want to know what challenges you're facing. And I'd love to chat with you about how I can help you accomplish that and build long-term wealth by acquiring more real estate. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys in the next one.